Hi friends, we will now read a poem which talks about coping with multiple tasks and multiple pressures. A person in a very high place, he is having so many tasks on hand, and he has a lot many pressures around, so he has to cope with all of them. He can't say, I am so worked up and I am having so many pressures, etc., etc. He has to understand that he is in such a position where lot many people come to him, lot many people, they peck him with so many questions, lot many people, they come to him seeking so much of help, etc., etc. So a person who is in such a place, he has to, suppose there is a leader, lot many people, they go to him, all the entire team people, they go to him and then they seek his help. So such a person, he can be a good leader only when he is able to cope with lot many issues and lot many problems and a lot of pressure. So this particular shloka is like that. So this shloka is from a book called Bhoja Prabandha. Bhoja Prabandha. Bhoja was a very renowned king of India. He lived probably in the 9th or 10th century AD. And then Bhoja Kalidasa poem stories, they are very, very popular. Bhoja Kalidasa stories are very popular. Though Kalidasa is said to be not a contemporary of Bhoja, somehow in tradition, this Bhoja Kalidasa stories have come into existence. Kalidasa seems to be an earlier poet. Earlier means some 4th or 5th century poet. And Bhoja was a king who lived in 10th century. But anyway, traditional stories are like that. But here, this Bhoja Prabandha tells the story of King Bhoja. The story of King Bhoja, his expeditions, how philanthropic he was and how he was such a learned man. He was a person who was entertaining all these poets every day. He was giving huge rewards to all these poets. Whoever was a great poet, he used to get great reward from this King Bhoja. So he was a very, very popular person among various writers, poets and all other men of learning. So this shloka is about him. So one day it seems there were so many visitors to him, and then he was short of cash in his, a king after all, he also has his treasury, isn't it? So in that treasury he was actually short of cash, but then lot many people were there, then what to do? So he was in a rather in a dilemma as to how to handle. So then it seems one poet who was present there and who watched the predicament of the king, he told this particular shloka. So this shloka, it doesn't refer to the king directly. It refers to a nice tree, a fruit-bearing tree, which is located on some crossroads, some big crossroads. So in that crossroads, there is a very big fruit-bearing tree. And it is also, the canopy is so vast. So people are going there, they take shelter under that. And then somebody pulls a small branch and then takes some leaves out of it. And then somebody throws stones and then tries to take the fruit. So all means are adopted to snatch fruits. They bend branches, they break branches, and then they throw stones, etc. All these things are there. So he is addressing that tree in this particular shloka. The poet is not addressing the king. The poet is addressing that tree. So it is called Anyapadesha. That particular alankara is called Anyapadesha. That is, I am talking to you, but instead of directly mentioning you, I am mentioning something else, which is something which is similar to you. The predicament there is something similar to your predicament. So this tree is located in the middle, which is accessible to all. It is not somewhere in the jungle. It is there in the village, at the crossroads. And then, if it is there, it can be there. But it is also having a very big canopy. It is also having fruits and it is also having flowers. So that is what is the problem. So that is the reason why everybody is coming to that. Everybody is sitting under that. Everyone is snatching and pulling its branches. Everyone is throwing stones on it. So that is the predicament. So the king, the poet, is describing that in this particular shloka. This is addressed to not the king. It is referring to the king, but addressed to the tree. It is referring to the king, but addressed to the tree. So let us read the shloka. Kim jatoshi chatushpathe.
Kim jatoshi chatushpathe.
Ghanatarachhayosi.
Ghanatarachhayosi.
Kim chayaya channaschet phalitosi. किं फलभरैः पूर्णोऽसि किं सन्नतः हे सद्वृक्ष
सहस्व संप्रतिचिरं
शाखाशिखाकर्षण क्षोभामोटनभञ्जनानि जनतः स्वैरैव दुश्चेष्टितैः. So the last word is very interesting. Svairaiva duschestitaihi. By your own mistake. By your own mistake, all these things are happening. Who asked you to be located there in the middle of that road? So, kim jatoshi chatushpathe. Jatoshi chatushpathe. Chatushpatha is a crossroads. Chatuhu is four. Patha is path. Four road junction. That four road junction, this tree is located in a four road junction. Why are you located in that four road junction? Then, ghanatara chayosi. Okay, you are located. You are not like some tall tree, not giving any trim, not giving any sort of shade. You are not like, say, a coconut tree. You are having a huge canopy. Ghanatara chayaha. Ghanatara. Ghana is very dense. Ghanatara chayosi. You are a person giving a lot of shade. Then, kim chayaya channaschet phalitosi. Why? What to talk about the shade? You are also giving phalitosi. Phala. Phala is a fruit, isn't it? Phalitosi. You are having lot many fruits. Then, kim phalabharaih purnosi. Why are you there with so many flowers, fruits and flowers? Why are you there with so many fruits? Kim sannataha. And why are you bending? Why are you so low? Low in the sense, you can actually pull the branches. It is, the canopy is not very, very high. It is also, it is something which you can stand and then you can just pull it. So, kim sannataha, it is also low. The canopy is also rather low. Then, kim balabharai purnosi. Then, kim sannataha, you are also bending. Then, he sadvurksha, oh my dear good tree. He sadvurksha is, oh my dear good tree. Sahasva. Sahasva means you endure, jolly well endure. What? Endure what? Samprati, now, chiram, always. Chiram means always. You have to endure. What? Shakha, shikha, karshana. Shakha means a branch. Shikha, shakha, shikha means the ends of the branches. The big branch cannot be, it can't be, broken. So the ends of these branches, the ends of the branches where actually these fruits, etc. are there. So, shakha, shikha, akarshana. Akarshana means pulling. Akarshanam, you know, yeah. The word dhatu, the dhatu karshanam means pulling. Shakha, shikha, karshana. Then kshobha. Kshobha is that pain. The pain, all that pulling of this, kshobha is shaking. Even that shaking also it can be meant. Then motana. Motana means something like crushing. You are breaking, crushing. And then bhanjana. Bhanjana is breaking actually. Bhanjana is breaking. Shobha is shaking, motana is crushing. So you are actually, you have to endure all that. Shobha, motana, bhanjanani. From all the people. Janataha. Janataha means from all the people. Svairaiva duschestitaihi. By your own mistake. Because you are there standing in the middle of the road. Not in the middle of the road. Standing in a four road junction. So that is what it is said. So this is something which is addressed to King Bhoja. On a particular situation where he was feeling rather perplexed, seeing a lot many visitors around him, and then he can't say no to any poet. So he was a person who was so generous to all the poets. And then, in fact, he was a great scholar. King Bhoja was a very great scholar. You can find lot many books on the internet written by King Bhoja. There is one book on architecture called Samarangana Sutradhara. Samarangana Sutradhara is a great book on architecture. And then similarly, he has written some other books on several subjects. He was a person, a multifaceted personality, who was a scholar in several fields. He knew poetry, he was a scholar in several other fields. So you can get lot many books also. So this generally is applicable, this shloka is not only applicable to King Bhoja, it is applicable to anybody who is in a high place. Suppose somebody who is a leader, somebody who is the boss. A boss cannot say, no, I am having a lot of pressure. You are the boss, you have to jolly well face it. You have to jolly well accept all the pressures. Otherwise, you can't be there. So, that is what it says. So, all such persons who are located in such high positions, In fact, they have to meditate. Meditate on this particular tree. Meditate yourself to be the fruit-bearing tree. That is the title I have given to this poem. That is, you have to meditate. Yes, I am the fruit-bearing tree. I have to bear all these things. Because I am the boss. I have to jolly well bear all these things. So, there is no one beyond me. So, if there is no one beyond me, I have to jolly well bear all these pressures in this particular office or in this particular organization. So, any particular leader is also in this situation. So, let us read the poem again. किं जातोसि चतुष्पथे
किं जातोसि चतुष्पथे
घनतरच्छायोसि
घनतरच्छायोसि
किं छायया
किं किं छायया
छन्नश्चेत् फलितोसि
छन्नश्चेत् फलितोसि
किं फलभरैः पूर्णोसि
किं फलभरैः पूर्णोसि
किं सन्नतः
किं सन्नतः
हे सद्वृक्ष सहस्व संप्रतिचिरम्
सहस्व संप्रतिचिरम्
शाखाशिखाकर्षण
शाखाशिखाकर्षण
क्षोभामोटन भञ्जनानि
क्षोभामोटन भञ्जनानि
जनतस्वैरैव दुश्चेष्टितैः
जनतस्वैरैव दुश्चेष्टितैः
फाइन.